everybody. We are going to talk about concentration cells. Now, we've already talked about voltaic cells. Concentration cells have the same idea going on, but we're going to have the EMF generated by the difference in concentration. So you're going to see we have almost identical cells in this case. The half cells are just going to be the reverse of each other. So whereas one is oxidizing, losing those electrons, the other cell is going to be gaining them. And still we're going to see that the anode is going to get smaller and the cathode is going to get bigger. So in this diagram here, I have a concentration cell using zinc and zinc sulfate. In the cell on the left, we have 1.8 molar, and then the one on the right, we have 0.0100 molar. The solution is zinc sulfate, and our anode and our cathode are pieces of zinc metal. Of course, we have the salt bridge there, and things are hooked up. But we need to figure out who's oxidizing, who is reducing, and where are the electrons going to be flowing from. So since these are going to be reverse of each other, our two half reactions are going to look like this. I'm going to start with the anode first, since that's going to be our source of electrons. So we are going to have zinc solid becoming zinc 2 plus, plus 2 electrons. Now I'm just getting that from what I'm seeing in the picture here. And then in the other cell, I don't know which cell it is yet because we haven't gone through that, but in the other one, I'm going to just have the reverse. I'm going to have that zinc 2 plus gaining those 2 electrons, and sorry my screen isn't keeping up with me, to form the zinc solid. So now we've got to figure out which one is which. What you need to know is that the dilute is going to be the anode. That's where our oxidation is going to occur. And then the concentrated one will, of course, be the cathode, where reduction is occurring. So when I am looking here, I'm going to look for my anode first. So that's going to be my dilute one. That's going to be the one on the right. This is where my source of electrons are going to be. So my zinc is going to become the zinc 2 plus, and my electrons are going to flow this way. So let's see, flow of E. This is my anode. And then over here is my cathode. The electrons are going to come down here, and the zinc 2 plus is going to grab those electrons and become that zinc 0. We are still flowing. Electrons are flowing from anode to cathode. The only difference here is that when we find our anode, we're going to find the one that is dilute. If I wanted to calculate the E cell, we're going to end up using the Nernst equation. The Nernst equation, remember, is non-standard conditions, and so since these aren't both at 1 molar, we're going to have to use the Nernst. That's going to be in the second video.